Tuesday, everybody. We're going live.
I'm just gonna Claremont
Club.
That makes more sense.
No, yeah.
I know, but I know.
Claremont Club bar class, high intensity. Take it down just a notch today from Tuesday. I'm still a little sore. I don't know about all of you, but still lots of glutes, lots of abs, lots of full body, lots of balance. And what we'll need today is a set of weights, something light. Any weights you have? A broom?
Why are you doing that?
I'm just observing something.
But your hand is across that screen every time.
No, it's not. No one can see my hand.
Ooh. Oh, nobody can see your hand there?
No.
You just darkened me, though.
Oh.
A lot.
Did
Why
I?
Did you mess around with it?
I did not. Mom, no, I didn't. Okay, continue.
I did. Totally.
No, I'm not doing that. No. Okay, it's fine. It's good.
No. That's so dark. It's so dark. Can I get up for a second?
Oh, yeah, that's probably better.
We kind of messed around with the resistance.
Oh, my God. It's fine.
You just turned the screen on. And you did it.
How did you do that?
I wanted to because
you're...
Okay, is it on now? Alright, there we go, we're better. Alright, here we go, Thursday, live bar. You're gonna need a broom. If you saw my goofy Instagram post, you'll see it. A broom, a can. If you have a ball rather than a can, you can use that. We're gonna have some light weights, a little bit of everything. We'll go about 50 minutes, and a little disclaimer, we're gonna shoot up on that screen for a second. Started.
Come on.
We're gonna start standing. So make sure you've got some room around you and also some water. Take a big breath in. Exhale as you open the arms all the way out. We're gonna do that one more time. Take a breath in. Jack, will you read the screen? Exhale as you reach all the way out. Flatten that back, round the lower back. Extend all the way out. And then release down. Bend your knees slightly.
Let's go.
Straighten your legs, bend those knees one more time, and straighten the legs. Stretch out those hamstrings, guys. Take advantage of it. Open your feet a little wider. And just take one arm around the ankle. Stay here for a second, and then to the other side. Bring both feet together once again, parallel. Bend those knees. Straighten the legs, deepen that stretch. Press one leg all the way back. I want you on the inside of that front leg to get into that inner thigh. And then lift all the way up. Rotate. Bring that arm all the way to the ceiling. Full rotation. Place that hand back down. Pull the back foot underneath you. Stretch it out. And then the other leg comes forward. You're in deep on the inside of that front leg. Get low into that inner thigh. Open that up. Drop back down into the front leg. Straighten it all the way out. Make sure that front leg is as straight as possible. If your hands can't stay on the floor, you can always place them on your quads. But you want to get that stretch in that hamstring and that back calf. Open the feet out, bend down, press those knees back. Push it to one side, rotating inward with that shoulder. And then the other way. Go ahead and release all the way down. Now a little deeper stretch in those inner thighs. Walk your hands to one side. Reach that arm all the way up. You give me la 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 la. Take advantage of the rotation and the stretch of the hamstrings. And then down. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. Start thinking about those abdominals. Stack your spine, bring your arms up and out. We're going to sink down into those legs. Pulling those knees back. Dropping your shoulders. Energy through your fingers. fingertips. I need you lower into those hips. Lift your right heel up. 4, 3, 2. Keep that heel up, and then the other heel lifts. 3, 2, and 1. We drop deeper for 8, 7. Melt into those legs. We're going to turn around into a lunge position, because we will have some lunges today. So I want you to make sure you get your positioning. Right now it's nice and slow. You're just rotating to the side. 2. Both legs even. Still energy through those fingertips. Come back to second. Open out. Drop low.
It will surely change even if I tell you I won't.
Another way. Down for a second. We're going to go ahead and lie down. You're going to grab that ball, can, whatever you've got underneath that hand. You're going to lie on your stomachs. I want you to warm up your backs today. We haven't done a lot of back work in the last 2 classes, so today I want you to really get that back going. Place your hands flat on that ball, can, whatever you've got that can roll. You're going to use your muscles to lift and lower. Don't jam into your spine. Think about those back muscles extensors. Lift.
Oh God, is there some way for me to take his place?
Try to keep that ribcage knitted. Abdominals engaged. We're going to stay up at the top and pulse.
And when they say,
2, 3, make those back muscles work.
Make it go away.
You're going to hold and just lift the right leg a little. Left. Make sure those abs are tight.
When no one's there.
4. Take one hand across your forehead. We're going to lift towards the ceiling. Open that chest. Focus on that side. This area is doing the work. 4, 3, 2, and 1. We go to the other side. So I'll be facing away from you. I need you to push slightly against that ball. Can, as you lift and rotate. 4 more.
Forgive my promise that you'll never see me cry.
And release down. Let's go into a shell stretch. Sitting back onto your heels, open your feet slightly so your knees are a little wider, and you're going to drop your head. Sink into your right side just a little bit. All your weight goes into that right. And then into your left. You do a series of side planks and side lines. So you're just going to lie on your side, still with that hand on that ball. Can, you're going to lift and lower. My hand, yes, it's on the ground, but I'm not killing it right here. Just a light touch. We're going to lift that top leg, stack still. So don't think you're going super high. Screen and get my dog out. One of these days, by the end of this quarantine, this will be a smooth. And I'm not gonna have to do it anymore. Lift. Technology, man. I'm working with it. you don't stay with me. You lay down now. Lift for 8 more. I don't know how many you did. 4, 3. We got 8 more little ones. So you lift 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. You ready to flip over onto that other side? Once again, this time on your knee, bottom knee, top knee, top leg is straight, bottom knee, and elbow is bent, pushing into that armpit. We're lifting and lowering, lifting. Let's focus on that side that's on the floor, pushing from that hip and waist. We speed it up. Come on up. Up. Go inside when I'm out here. Come on, you got 2 more eights. You doing it? Up. One more eight. Power through that side. Push that floor away from you with that supporting elbow and armpit. And we rest. Let's go to the other side. Bottom knee is bent. Top leg is straight. We'll be on the floor for a little bit longer. We lift and lower. Lift, lower. Top leg should be a little more fatigued right now. Let's go. 7, 6. All the way. Up. 8. 8 more. 8, 7. Probably not the best spot for him, huh? 3, 2, 8 more times here. 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab a sip of water. Grab your weight. If you don't want to put a weight behind your knee today, that's fine. We're just going to go into our glutes here. Come here. So grabbing your weight. We're going to make it a little different. We're going to do alternating. So we're going to start with the knee bent and then do a big series with a straight leg. Then go the other side. So you put that weight behind your knee if you like. Flex and lift. Right away, I want you to think about changing your angle. Pull that knee inward, so you're rotating in from that hip a little. Turn that knee out. Bring that knee all the way in front of you. Forward, back, forward, back. I need to make sure you feel that hip completely opening and lifting, opening. Keep the knee to the side and give me some circles. Reverse your circle. Pull straight up behind you. 2 8s only. It's as tiny, as small, as concise as you can make it. 8 more. Go ahead and drop that. Come up onto your hands and lift that leg. Nice long lift. Staying high with that leg. Up. Swing the leg forward and back. Swing it. Stay strong on your supporting side. Stay back. Lift. Finger tap now to the floor. Up that leg, across, and lift it forward, across. So as big as you can with that leg. You're switching from one side to the other. Also using that waist. Let's do 8 more here. Come on, down. 7. 4 more. Strong torso, 3 strong abs. Lift that leg behind you. Flex your foot now. Give me a little more height. Maybe let's go back down on those elbows. Stronger, tighter, heel to ceiling, or sky, up. Hold it and flex your foot. Contract into that hamstring, pulling that heel to your glute as you flex and then extend. Staying on your elbows, lift high, strong. Flex that foot one more time. Don't sink into your bent knee, your supporting leg. 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest. Let's sit back onto your heels. Stretching it out. Dropping to that side that you just worked, that extended leg. Let those hips wake up, shake out, stretch out a little. And then let's grab that weight, placing it back behind your other leg. You're holding onto that weight if you have one. If you don't have something behind your knee, just pretend you do and squeeze. I'm going to turn around at an angle as we get down to this one. So you can see which way I'm going with my knee. We lift. No, go. The other day it was so good. Jacqueline! You know, gotta keep it live. I want to do one of these videos with all the bloopers that have happened from the beginning when I first started this to now. I could make a nice video of just all of the goof-ups. He keeps walking right in front of the screen. We have those circles. And reverse. Go straight up again. Pulse. Up. We're coming up onto our hands. Drop that weight. And lift. Long lift. High leg. Co-host is gone. Leg forward and back. Swing it forward, guys. High legs. Stay behind you. Flex that foot. Lift it. Stronger through those shoulders. Don't sway in those lower backs. Make sure your abs are tight. Let's come back onto our elbows. Get a little more extension. A little more height, a little more lift, up, up, up. Eight. Oh, we forgot those big ones where I need you to cross all the way over. So cross, lift, cross, lift, cross. You're taking that leg all the way over your body. High. Flex that foot. Stay a little higher. Come back down on those elbows. Strong through that core. Flex and point your foot. Squeeze. Press. Deliberate motion here. You pull. You press. Resist in every direction. 4, 3, 2, 1. And rest. Once again, let's sit back onto those heels, stretch it all the way out, sink into the hip that, again, that leg that was just lifted, sink into that hip, stretch it out. So I try, like I always say, to really switch it up almost every time I do this, so let's go ahead and grab a weight again. If you have different sizes, maybe a heavier one, you're going to go into a hip bridge. So I think we all know, when you're lying down in that bridge position, working everything. You're working that whole back chain of your body. You're working your abs. Obviously, we're working our glutes. We're going to focus a little on inner thighs just by changing our positions. But we also are going to incorporate triceps. So we're going to press
Does help get those muscles ready to go again. Bend that other knee in. Even across. We're going to go into a set of push-ups. And some. Another series of planks.
We haven't done any yet. Why don't we start with our planks? Go up to some push-ups. Go back into planks. We'll make it fun. On your elbows and legs are long, push. I need you to rock forward. So right now, your shoulders, lats, rear delts, even triceps are doing that work to rock your body forward and back. Your body is as long and strong as possible. Pressing that floor away from you with those shoulders. And anytime you need to drop on your knees, please do. We are alternating, just one knee at a time dropping. Making those obliques fire a little more. Four, three, both knees drop. Slow. When you drop, I want you to focus a little bit more on feeling those lower abdominals. Pulling that belly button to your spine. You drop your hips to the right, swivel to the left, to the right, to the left. Four more. It's like you're twisting your lower body off of your upper body. That doesn't sound good, does it?
And
sit back.
Drop your head.
Prepare your upper body and chest and strength. Just focusing on the front now as we go into some push-ups. Let's go on your knees. The other day I did them on on your feet. So you're in a push-up position on your elbows. I mean, with wide elbows on your hands. We're going to go down in pieces. And press up forward. Down, down. Press forward. It's all about control right here. Drop, drop.
Hold and hover.
Press that forward. There's no rush. Drop, drop.
You hover.
And you press through those armpits as you press that floor away. We got about five more. Drop. Stop.
You stop.
Press. You want to do them on your hands? You do them on your hands. I get more depth when I'm down here. I want to go all the way down and then press. Three more, everybody. One, two.
Hover.
And press. Let's do two more.
Hover.
Press. Pulse, 8, 7. Chest up, chin up, I mean. Chest is trying to touch that floor. You want to do eight more? Let's go. And rest. Sitting back into those heels. Actually, keep your butt up a little bit more to get a little more stretch into those shoulders.
Drop your head.
Feel that stretch here. Make our planks a little bigger. You're going to be on your hands. If you have any wrist issues, go on your elbows. You can still get it up. You're going to cross your knee. You're going to open. You're going to hold. You're going to plank. And you're going to lift. So we're going to cross. You're going to open. Hold. Plank. Lift. Four more. Cross. Open. Hold flat. Cross. Again, stabilizing through that shoulders. And back. Cross. Open. Hold. Right. And lift one more time. Cross. Open. Hold flat. Right. And lift. Got it. Extend out. And every week we'll be building on those. If you're keeping track, we started with just crossing. We add in the plank. We add in the leg. This is what we come up with for Saturday. We have the other side to do, huh? Let's take it up. I'm gonna stay on this side just so you can see the angle from both sides. And again, I can always figure out what works best after I rewatch it. Thank you. Every time I say thank you, it's because I'm thanking you, one, for being here. But I see a little thumbs up, and that helps. Because it makes me know, because I can't see anything else. The things are working out well. All right. Maybe I should say that more often, huh? Don't worry, you're not going to get out of this other side, though. Forward. Cross. We stop. You lift. And up. We cross. We open. We stop. Stronger, tighter. Across your body. Every part of your body is working right now. That's why these are so good. Cross. And open. Pipe. Lift. We cross. Open. One last two sets. Two more sets. A big lift. And believe me, you will feel progression the more you do this. So if you feel like you're not getting your leg up as high as you might like, don't worry about that. Stand out. Just start standing. Let's go ahead and go up. We all got a broom? If you don't have a broom, you'll have it a little easier because you'll have something to hold on to. We're going to do a series of standing leg work. Hold on to a little bit. So I'm smart. I got a broom with a bigger base. So it's not that easy. I just have a little bit of bigger bass. I started with a little Swiffer. Didn't quite cut it. Hand on that bump, move. Feet parallel. Chest is lifted. Bodies are strong. We're gonna releve and lower. Lift. I want you to zip those inner thighs together. Place your hand on your hips. You can take it out. And that guy's there for support. It'll make you really realize that your body weight is super even among both feet and over all 10 toes. Warming up those calves. We're going to hold our heels as high as possible and drop into those mini bends. Chest is up. Here we go, a little lower. You got two more eights. I want paper legs, higher heels. Don't forget about those heels. Eight more. Strong. Stay low now. Fight right here. Open and close those knees. Open. 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 You've got four more. Three, two, and relax. I don't know what happened. Somebody trying to get on the other. They know I'm doing this. But they forget. Heels together, toes apart, shoulders down, lift and lower. Now you're in that slight turnout. All the weight is still even on all 10 toes. You're not falling back on those baby toes. Press. And still feeling like you're zipping those inner thighs together. You'll feel different muscles working in the different rotations. Parallel is different. You're going to keep those knees pulled back using those glutes. Drop. Try not to let your hips sway back too much. Directly down. Energy through those fingertips if your arm is out. Or here on your hand is fine. On your hip. Can you get a little more depth? Times. Three, two, and one. Relax. All right, we got one more set. Second position. Be ready. We're going to drop the broom. We're going to pick it up. We're going to drop it. We're going to pick it up. So you get an exercise just going down to get it. Because I want to add some jumps in between. Let you off easy the other day. Put it in. So bring your arm forward. Right now, inner thighs hip together. Lift. And remember, you don't want to jump? Don't jump. I'll cue the other version in a minute as well. Right now, I just want you to fire through those legs. Fire. Push. Push. All of the energy from the bottom of your feet, your insteps, your metatarsals, your inner thighs kind of pull together even though those legs are separated. Let's go eight quicker. Energy, guys. Six, five, four, three. We stay up with those heels and we drop. Those knees are once again being pulled back. Those booties are pulling those knees back. So if you look from the side, you're trying to create that openness. Chest is lifted. Ready? We drop that broom. You don't want to jump, you just stay low. Otherwise, we power. Spring, spring, spring. We've got eight. You need to stop, stop. Take it parallel, parallel, parallel. Four, three, two, eight more. Drop, guys. And rest. Go ahead and come back. Grab that little sucker. Go back into that wide stance. Push that floor away. Push, catch your breath. Extend. those muscles are awake or woken up. Maybe they were already awake. But now, feel more. Feel it all. Feel high. Knees back. Walk. Notice the height of my heels. Not there, but there. Can we go lower? Just one more eight, but slow. Focus on the depth. Lift. We've got 4, 3, 2, 1. Can we hold it? Balance, abs, glutes, legs. Relax. Do a little back work. Once again, really in the bar class is the only time you're getting all that work through the back of the leg, back of the body. Unless you're a dancer. So right now is what I want you to do. If you feel like grabbing your weight, or you can, grab it. I'm going to take it to give you a little more shoulder work. So you're going to press your arm out while your leg lifts. Pull. If the pull is too challenging for your balance, go ahead, place your hand on the chair, bar, top, whatever you've got. You've got 8 more. And remember what I said about back work. If your abs are not engaged, that spine will take it. So you need to make sure, hold on a second, that you are so lifted, that rib cage is knitted. So these muscles that support your spine are the ones that are doing the work right now. Obviously also, those are what's attached to the glutes, so that whole back chain of your body is working. You had a break? We got some quick ones. Let's go. Lift, 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 lift. Tiny. Stronger. Breathe. Notice my arm is not going all the way down. It's staying lifted so that shoulder is active. Point those toes if you can. 4, 3, 2. Keep that fire. 8, 7, 4. Rest. Other side. Arc. So that range of motion is right here. Making that front and side part of that shoulder doing the work the whole time. So if you drop, you lose it. 2 8 slow. If I can. Whoop! Still happening, and don't let your body open. Everything should be squared off to that wall or whatever you got in front of you. So you're really isolating right in here. While waiting for the music, catch your breath, drop your shoulders, tighten those abs. Feet are turned out. Okay, that's what's going to change that positioning and change the way the muscles work with that lateral rotation. 6, 7. We're going to be lifting. 4, 8. 7. Up. Strong 4. You feel a little wobbly, that's absolutely fine. Nice long arms, long feet, long legs. Stand. 8 more, guys. 7. 5, moving it. 4, 3, 2, and rest. Drop that back. Rotate, extend out, lift. feel like I know you all, so I'm going to talk for a second. We got some side work. But I had a cool text today from a friend of mine who moved away and is a Pilates coordinator now for a big gym in Colorado. And she said her gym was looking through different things that we're doing right now and pulled up a picture of me and said, look at what the Claremont Club is doing. And she goes, wait, I know her. I used to work with her. So it just shows that I think we're doing a good job as a club and all in all to keep you guys all active. And other clubs are looking at it, so it's kind of nice. Anyway, let's do some side work. You're going to be using your waist. Once again, in that turned out position, arm is up. I'm going to kick you a little bit off some lunges. We're going to go a little lighter on our lunges today. Arm is out. So a little bit more of this kind of combination work. Lift and lower. Lift. I want you to make that waist do the work to pull the knee up. Eight more times. Pull that knee in. And again, if you want a weight or something in your hand, have it. A water bottle, wine bottle, I don't know. If not, just isolate through that shoulder. That's perfectly fine. Let's go to the other side. Lift, reach. And you only take that leg as high as it can go. Right now it's about obliques. A different way of working your obliques. Standing. Balance. Quad, hip flexor, supporting leg, shoulders obviously, four, at least I'm getting a like and a heart, even though I talk so much. Anyway, trying to keep you involved, and I can't be there to watch your form, so you're going to try to walk you through it, talk you through it, right now, this leg is out to the side, 4-8, guys, focus on that bend. Side, up, up, lift. Energy through those shoulders up and pull down through the lat. Supporting leg is solid. Eight more, yeah? No rest. Other side. We get a little more bend there. Create that bend. Lift that elbow to your knee, or lift your knee to your elbow. Last eight. Four. I don't know about you, but I can tell I haven't been doing enough of that. So, again, I'm going to be putting it back and forth. Right now, drop that pan. Grab a weight. Let's take a little lighter one. You don't want a weight? I know I say that all over. Grab a can. Don't have a weight at all. We are going to do one set of curtsy squats with quite a bit of balance. So, same arms as leg. Supporting leg is here. You're going to drop across that body, lift, drop. So let's just do a couple super slow like this. So you get your body position. Let's do the other leg. So you get the other side. You drop. You press. You drop across that body. And you press. And relax. So again, you see how much of your body is working there. Your shoulder, obviously. Weight, no weight, pressing up. Whole supporting leg, that glute once again. You ain't done yet. We got another quick set. Now that y'all have it, we go all the way down. Cross behind you and diagonally. Drop, lift, drop. Lift, drop, lift, drop. Just go with me. Drop, lift, drop. It's more than just desire. Burns in me like fire. Moves the light. leg up.
Tap if you need to. Otherwise, stay off. Pressing through that shoulder. You're gonna go into that curtsy squat, holding that arm up. Press. So you see that shoulder. I'm still pressing. Relax. All right. Other side. Crossing that leg all the way over. So it is not your average lunge, it's your curtsy squat. So that leg has to cross diagonally. Lift, lower, and lift, lower, and lift, lower, lift, press. Try to stop at the top for that split second. Into those little curtsies and press. Lean forward a little. Eight more. And relax. Let's stretch out those shoulders for a second. Just bring one arm across the other. Other arm across. You can take it above the head if you'd like. Do a couple circles and reverse your circles. We're gonna do a big combination one. So you're gonna go into some biceps and into a almost like a deadlift. So I'm gonna do it this way. The weight is in the same leg that is lifting. So opposite of the standing leg. You're gonna draw down. You're going to lift, and you're going to give it a bicep curl at the top. So you're going to draw it down, lift, find that curl. Okay, we'll speed that up a little bit. Drop, and curl. Full drop, and lift. Tight abs. I need the work to come from that back leg of the standing leg. Drop. Ton of balance work here. Coordination, hamstring, bicep, back, glute, anything else? Come on, obliques. We're gonna hold it right here and just pulse for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, try to go into that T and rock. You're gonna hold that T and you're gonna curl. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax. Other side. Glide that weight across the front of that leg. We hinge. 4. We curl. Focus on that standing leg. The work between the glute and the knee. That hinge is coming from your hip. Your abs are completely engaged. There should be nothing in the back. You hold it here and we pulse for 8, 7. Smaller range of motion here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, we go down and we tilt. four, three, two. You hold and you pull for eight. Slower, seven, six, five, three, two, and one. We're gonna finish off with a little more biceps. So this time I want you really turned out with that arm that's working. Just as the hips are turned out, you're in that rotation from the hips. Same thing with that arm. We're curling up and down while you extend your leg out to the side. So let's go. Lift, bring it all the way in, up, all the way in. Energy through the leg that's going up. Push. Lift. Keep that arm turned out, guys. Eight more. Up. So again, that balance. That opposition. A lot of things going on at once. So you're getting your money's worth. Legs. Abs. Biceps. Arm out to your side. Whoop. And again, feel like that inner thigh is drawing that leg down, but you're not letting it plump. Energy. Change it. Change your angle. Your leg is going forward and back. I'm going to angle sideways so you don't get my foot in your face. Front and back. Forward and back. Forward. Back. Just four more. That's basically just for some balance. Three. Your weight. Completely parallel. Hammer curl. Lift. Lower. Lift. Lower. Strong into that supporting leg. Chest is high. Elbow is not swinging. Three, two, one. Let's do eight tiny pulses, leg included. Seven, six, four, three, two. Relax. Other leg. I'm gonna sway that leg, swing it forward and back. You're swinging it forward and back, forward, back, forward. Again, that's for balance challenge. That change of direction is huge. You're gonna bring the arm forward, forward, tap. Isolate, don't sway. Set those shoulders down and back. We speed it up. Relax, drop that weight. And we gotta finish off with some abs. Time flies when you're having fun. Alright. One little mini set. Again, wrist issues. 30 seconds, 45 seconds. Unless there's something that's really bugging you. Probably not gonna affect you too much. Get your pants right under your buttocks, glutes, and then shove those hips up. Please, guys, try to keep your gaze forward once you see the position up here, okay? Your bend is coming from the elbows. My hips will naturally drop a little. You like those, really? All kinds of, like, thumbs up flying. Crazy. Lift and lower. Tighten those abs. Drop. Drop. And guess what? Right here, your abs are working. I try to cheat you and give you abs even though you don't think you really want them. I'm not cheating you. I wouldn't want to do this without you. Come on, we're not done. Sorry, I'm just changing my angle so you can see. Drop. Right leg lifts. You got eight more. Whoop. Other leg. Keep those hips high. Both hips up and lower both legs down. go ahead and lean back on your elbows. Chest is lifted. Abdominals are engaged. Back is hollowed out down here, so there's no pressure in those lower backs. Let's scissor your legs. One shot that we fire at the sky, but this time we are together. Single. Right here in this moment where we belong. Bend the knees and shoot them out together. Tuck. Shoot them out. Tuck. Oh, and one thing. Starting next week, Tuesdays and Thursdays, I will be going live at 5. So we've got a couple requests to go a little earlier. So I think 5 will be just fine. 3, 2, here, we can always change it. But next week, 5 o'clock, on your back. Double tap, high your chest. Place your feet down. Behind your head, reach one hand to that opposite knee. Give me both shoulders off the floor. Up. Other way. So you're rotating towards that other knee, keeping those lower abs really, that belly button pulled in as you rotate as much as you can. Both hands reach. 8. I need your chest and shoulders higher as you focus to keep that contraction. Hold it there and scooch. Right. Left. Place one hand behind your head and just stay to that one side. Pulse. Pulse. It's a little different. You're sliding that hand towards your knee. Other side. Sliding that hand towards your other knee. 4. Hands above your head, coming all the way up, and then you're going to hold and pulse, pulse, stay contracted, stay small. We're finishing it off here, so guys, just fight, lean back as far as your body will allow. Twist, twist, twist. Keep your knees slightly in the opposite direction. 8. Other way. 2, and relax. Go ahead and lie down, right knee to your chest. I got booted off again. We'll talk. So bring that knee into your chest. Take that hand across, actually the other hand across all the way over. Open that knee, open that chest. Bend that knee into your chest. Roll that knee around a couple times. So within that hip socket, you're just kind of stretching it out. And then go ahead and extend that leg to the ceiling, to the sky. Give it a good stretch. Bend the knee again. And stretch it out again. And then we'll go the other way. Bend that knee in. Cross all the way over. Bend it back. Roll that knee around right here in that hip joint. Socket. And then extend that leg up to the ceiling. Bend the knee back. Reach it up again. Bend both knees in. Draw them really close to your chest. Rock side to side a couple times. Forward and back. Sit up. Extend out and over those legs. Bending one knee at a time. So just enabling that straight leg to get a nice stretch, releasing the other one. Bend one knee in slightly and just full rotation to the back. And then do that with the other knee. And we are all done for Thursday afternoon. Thank you very much from all of us here at the club, from me, Roya. Hope to see you Saturday morning, and time has changed as well for that. We're going a little earlier so you guys can get your day going. 10:15 on Saturday, all right? So take a good day.
I'm gonna take you with me for a little while here till I can finish it. Jacqueline?